Earth Hellas Basin Exploration Mission Podcast. Today's date is Friday, February 17th, 2012, and I'm your host, Kate Anderson. Today, we will discuss the selection of a Mars rover landing site within the Hellas Basin region of Mars. The Hellas Basin is a science-rich location that may help us to understand more of the history of Mars, as well as a location that will help NASA prepare for future human exploration of the Red Planet. The Hellas Basin is one of the largest impact craters in the solar system. It was likely formed on Mars during the late heavy bombardment period of the solar system about 4.1 to 3.8 billion years ago when a very large asteroid struck Mars. The impact basin is 7,152 meters deep and extends about 2,300 kilometers east to west. The altitude difference between the rim and the bottom is 9 kilometers. The crater floor is the lowest region on Mars and has nearly twice the atmosphere as other regions. The atmospheric pressure within the basin is 89% higher than elsewhere and is above the triple point of water, meaning that water could be in a liquid phase on the surface for short periods of time rather than sublimate due to low atmospheric pressures. The Mars-Hellas Basin Exploration Mission is intended to explore the impact basin for proof of frozen or liquid water below the surface in the form of glacier or paraglacial deposits. This mission will also analyze surface soils for evidence of ultraviolet exposure and measure radiation levels within the basin. These measurements will allow NASA scientists to conclude if the additional atmosphere within the basin provides sufficient protection from cosmic and solar radiation to allow for safer future human exploration. NASA has four goals that drive their focus and exploration of Mars. The Hellas Basin Exploration Mission's two primary goals are to better characterize the climate of Mars and to understand Martian geology. In addition, it has a secondary goal of preparing for future human exploration of the planet. Mars's current climate is too dry and cold to allow for liquid water to exist on the surface. Scientists have found lots of evidence that suggests liquid water once flowed on the surface of the planet. Evidence for past and current water is promising within the Hellas Impact Basin. The focus of this exploration will be the Hellas Basin's possible glacial structures as well as the exposed layered bedrock within the crater. This mission will consist of a robotic lander and rover capable of testing for water content, mineral abundance, as well as type, as well as monitor for cosmic and solar radiation at the surface. The site selected offers an excellent location for examining glacial and periglacial features in the crater. These images show what scientists believe are subsurface glaciers of solid water. These glaciers are protected by a layer of dust and rock that insulates the water underneath, preventing it from sublimating into the Martian atmosphere. Scientists compare these Martian images to similar patterns in glaciers on Earth. Within the landing area, there are several high-rise images taken of similar features for study. Thermos imagery of Mars indicates high silica deposits of an aqueous origin within the landing region. These deposits are indicative of periodic water within the basin. Closer examination of the mineralogy of the soils and rocks within the massive crater will shed new light on our understanding of Mars's past. Because it is a large impact basin, deep rocks not normally seen on the surface should be visible within the impact crater walls, providing information to planetary geologists about the geologic history of Mars. The depth of the crater provides an opportunity to study the shielding properties of the Martian atmosphere for future human research. The landing site is located 6 kilometers from the glacial deposits identified in the high-rise imagery, in order to preserve the sterility of the research site. There is a gentle upward slope of approximately 3% between the landing site and the study area. This mission will require the use of a rover capable of traversing rough terrain. The rover will gather geological data through the use of a geologic drill and soil scoop, similar to the instruments used on previous rovers. The rover will need to be able to analyze samples on its own. The rover will utilize a heat shield to protect the scientific instruments from damage during its entry into the Martian atmosphere. This landing site within the Hellas Basin will be deeper into the Martian atmosphere than previous Martian landers and rovers, so additional shielding may be required. Because of the desire to preserve the integrity of the study site, a sky crane system will be used. similar in design to that of Curiosity. Because the Hellas Basin is located far in Mars' southern hemisphere, solar panels will likely not provide sufficient power to operate the rover. A radioisotope power source will be a better option. It has been more than 40 years since human beings walked on an object other than our planet Earth. Cosmic and solar radiation is a huge threat to human beings and their ability to visit our planetary neighbors. The additional atmosphere within the Hellas Basin can provide additional radiation shielding for astronauts. The basin could become a viable option for future human exploration. In addition, the Hellas Basin region offers a chance for scientists to explore subsurface ice and water deposits, as well as look for evidence for ancient coastlines that are all that remains of the once large sea that likely filled the crater. This information will help planetary geologists reconstruct the Martian surface and may shed illumination on whether biogenesis occurred on Mars as well as on Earth. Thank you for listening to today's podcast about the Mars Hellas Basin exploration mission. We are on the edge of understanding fascinating new information about the history of Mars, as well as preparing for human exploration beyond our own Earth-Moon system. Please join us for our next podcast as we examine further engineering concerns and constraints for this mission.